Spotlight On, and I'm your host today, Dara Jones.
Hi, I'm Barbara Gandica, I'm her co-host.
And today we're speaking with Cecilia Stevenson, a professional video producer, and she's here to talk with us today about COVID-19 and quarantine. And Cecilia knows a lot about quarantine. She and her two roommates spent a lot of time together, you know, back in March. And out of that spawned this wonderful creative kind of venture that you did. Can you kind of introduce us to your thought process as you went into making a video about it?
Yeah, sure. Well, it was back in, good grief, I think it was March. Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I think it was back in March, kind of when people were starting to like, oh, this is getting serious. Oh my gosh. And then Dallas shut down for the first time. It was shelter in place for 2 weeks. And we're like, oh my gosh, 2 weeks shelter in place. That's so long. And then, you know, kind of the end of the 2 weeks came and they're like, we're extending shelter in place until, you know, 30 more days. And we were like, oh my gosh, 30 more days. This is crazy. And then we were like, we have all this time now and we're home alone. Just the three of us, like all day, every day, like we should make a parody video. One of my roommates, she's done improv comedy. And she's super into comedy. I of course have video experience. The other roommate, she's been in modeling and has like being on camera experience. So we all just kind of very, creative just minds. And so we're like, yeah, let's do something creative with all this time that we have. So, we just started brainstorming, kind of all of the funny things about being in quarantine together. And we picked a song, we picked Lady Gaga's Poker Face, and then just sat down. Honestly, like it took us a couple evenings of just sitting down and like going through Lady Gaga's lyrics, and just kind of like reworking the phrases and the rhyming to fit all of these like funny experiences that we were experiencing as three roommates living in quarantine together. And over the course of a couple of weeks, we just like filmed it a little bit at a time, and then I edited it together. And now we have the final product, and it got we released it, and within the first 24 hours, we had like, I think 1,000 views. Like it was a very fun 24 hours. We were just like all sitting around the house together, and like, we'd all be like checking like, oh my gosh, another 100 views. Oh my gosh, we hit 400 views. Ah! It was a very fun. And like all of our friends were like sharing it, and just like people that we didn't know were commenting and were sharing it. And it was kind of wild. Just this fun little video that we made, and people were watching it and enjoying it. So it was
Speaking of that, let's watch it together.
Yeah.
Worked out too hard. Oh, well, now we're shot. Gave it all we got. Go. touch your face. Don't touch your face. Stay home, mama. No, don't touch your face. Don't touch your face. Stay home, mama. I will tell you that I love you, but won't hug you, cause I'm stuffing with my muffin. I'm not crying, I'm just shutting with my hot glue gunning. Just like a chicken Florentino, face mask on us when we must go out. Then promise this, promise to stay inside and we'll flat.
That was awesome. It's awesome every time I watch it. It's great.
Oh, I never get bored of watching that.
Well, so you put some Easter eggs in there, I see.
Yeah, there's a few little goodies. There's a, yeah, a few little references.
Share with us.
Gosh, let me pull up the lyrics. So there's a Harry Potter reference with the little, she wants freedom just like Dobby, and we throw a sock at her. I don't know if people can see the video, if this is a podcast, but there's a Dobby reference.
I love the bar on the Zoom meeting. I was like, I can relate to that so much.
Yes, there's like so many little things that were, they're just like, we tried to kind of capture, like I said earlier, what it was like, or has been like, I guess, just living in quarantine, like experiences that everyone will be able to relate to. Like you said, the wearing sweatpants when you're on a Zoom call, you know, you have to put on a nice top, but like I'm literally wearing like workout pants right now. going grocery shopping, like for the first, at least for us, the first few weeks, it was like a production, you know. We tried to only limit ourselves, like each of us could go once a week. I tried to do it once every 2 weeks. So, and it felt like going out into this war zone, you know. And so in the video, we have like, you know, the rubber gloves, and she's wearing a hazmat suit and goggles. And it's just kind of like what it felt like to go grocery shopping, which is such a just normal day experience. But I'm sure we're not the only ones that felt like we were going into war zone going grocery shopping. So funny. I mean, all the stuff about like wanting to see your friends, but like not being able to, obviously, I'm sure lots of people can relate to that. The YouTube dancing, that was one of the more fun. We really enjoyed filming that part.
That was amazing.
We're big on mostly my other two roommates. They go to like yoga classes and like, I don't know, they'll do all these like fitness classes and stuff. And so like when all that was canceled, we're like, shoot, like what are we gonna do for our workouts now? So we would, you know, we watch like different like YouTube, there's like all these YouTube guys that'll like do like dance workout and routine. And so we'd be like, you know, traipsing around the house, like running laps around the kitchen counter island, or just like doing push-ups in the living room and just like dancing anyway. So that one, I'm not sure if other people can also relate to having to do the home workouts now instead. Let me see what else. I was gonna say the whole at the very beginning, wish I had some hobbies, guess I'll try my hand at art. It kind of seemed like everyone was now that we're home all the time and we have all this free time and we can't go anywhere, we can't see anyone, like sure, you could just watch like TV the whole time, and we certainly like did watch our fair share of movies and TV, but then we're like, well, yes, let's like do some art projects, or let's like pick up a new hobby, or let's like learn how to do something, or, you know, let's make a music video. So that one was pretty relatable, I think, for a lot of people. I don't know. And then like the whole concept of just losing kind of your sense of time, and like, really, like, I don't know what day it is, you know, when you're in quarantine, and like every day is just kind of the same and you're just stuck at home with the same people doing the same things. And you're like, I don't know if it's Monday. I don't know if it's Tuesday. I don't know, you know, what time of day it is. gosh, yeah. We pizza from the local shop. That was literally pizza that we ordered from the local shop. And pretty sure they didn't charge a delivery fee. No one was charging, or lots of places were waiving the delivery fees because they knew everyone was at home and ordering out because we were trying to, you know, support local restaurants and whatever. So everyone was kind of doing their part to like just help people out.
Now, you know, I had not seen Poker's Place before, and my roommate watched it. She's like, oh my gosh, you know, they hit all the high spots.
Yeah. The actual Poker Face, it's very different. Ours is much more family friendly, but
better actually.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, we tried to get all the like the timing, and we'd be like counting syllables. We'd be da 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 da, like when we were like writing out the lyrics. So we wanted it to be good, and I think we did a pretty good job.
So were the lyrics like a group project, or did folks take on different sections? How did that go?
It was very collaborative. We'd just be like sitting around the living room, and I would read out the Lady Gaga lyrics, and we'd kind of get the rhythm and okay the rhyme and okay, and we tried to match the rhymes that she did. And so then we kind of had a list of just like the funny ideas, like, you know, the sweatpants, like wearing sweatpants on Zoom calls, or just like going for walks was like the only thing that anyone was allowed to do, you know, outside of the house. So we like put in a line about walks, you know, like of delivery, ordering out. So we just had like all of these ideas of just quarantine things. And then we kind of had the rhyme, the Lady Gaga rhyme, and just kind of, you know, fixed them around, and I'm really proud of how it turned out, actually. And I don't get tired of watching it. I still think it's funny, and I've seen it, you know, several dozen times, so. And I like had the whole thing memorized, right? So
you've been in quarantine, but later, yes. Barbara's going to ask you about this. You've had the COVID-19.
We did a good job of quarantining. And then I went to a wedding, which, you know, I have no regrets. I'm glad I went. It was a dear friend. And I went with other really good friends. And so we had a really great time. I don't regret going. But I did get COVID-19. Turned out actually the bride and groom at the wedding, after the fact, both tested positive. And so then several of us actually who had gone up for the wedding, we all like carpooled. It was in another city. We'd all carpooled together. So several of us, I was the only one that had like the fever and like the really intense symptoms, but they were like tired, fatigued, lost sense of taste and smell. So like, we're pretty sure we have COVID, but I was the only one that actually got tested. But yep, tested positive.
I remember that in the beginning of the pandemic and all, like the beginning month, now that I feel like it was the beginning years now, but the beginning month, there was a lot of questions about how to get tested and whether you should get tested even if you're feeling bad, and there was a lot of, oh, you have to call your doctor, or probably you should, if you're feeling bad, like you should just assume that you have it. How did you go about getting tested during those times?
So you're right, I think I wanted to get tested even like before the fact, just because like I'm going to a wedding like with a bunch of people, and I don't want to take COVID to them if I'm like asymptomatic or whatever. But you're right, like when I looked into it, it like you did have to have certain symptoms in order to get tested, or you had to have like a doctor's like note or whatever. Like they were being very strict, at least in Dallas, I think, with who they were letting get tested, perhaps because they had such limited number of tests. So I wasn't able to get it when I had no symptoms, which I guess that makes sense. Still, it was just like, I want that peace of mind, you know, where I want to like, I just want to know, but I couldn't. But then I did have symptoms, and I was like, okay, well, now I definitely should get tested. And now I definitely could get tested. And honestly, like the process itself, I had to wait. I had to like book my little appointment. I decided to do, I don't have normal insurance. So, I was kind of like limited in my search, but I found that CVS does, they do like the free testing basically. So like I heard about that and I like looked up, and I just had to like make an appointment. And they were booked like 2 or 3 days in advance. So it was like Monday or something I was looking, and I was able to, I think, book it on like Wednesday. And there's like several different options, you know, like you can do the rapid test, you can do the antibody test, you can do the, like the slow test that's like supposedly more accurate or something. And I opted for the slow test that's supposedly more accurate. But it was very slow. So I got tested. The actual getting tested itself was, it was super straightforward and easy. I literally drove to the CVS. They had like signs, you know, go to the drive-thru. So I went in the drive-thru, maybe had to wait like 3 minutes in the drive-thru. I was there at my appointment time and then I drove up. And the lady, I forget, she put like a bag in the little, tray, the extender tray at the drive-thru. And so she put this like bag in there, extended it. And then she was talking to me on the microphone and she's like, I'm going to give you a call. Okay. And I was like, okay, great. So then she called me on my cell phone and I'm like looking at her, like she's up in like the CVS window. And so like, I can see her and she's like on the phone. And so she called me and then she just kind of walked me through, like, okay, like you're going to get the bag and you're going to open the bag and then you're going to see two other small Ziploc bags. So take out the first one with the little, it's got a couple wipes in it and a piece of paper. So take that and put that aside and then take out the second one. Okay. Yep. There you go. You see that. And then there was the, like the stick thing with like the swab, whatever on the end. And she kind of just like walked me through it. And she was like watching me the whole time. And she was like, yep, that's the one. And then like, okay, now rip that open and da 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 whatever. And she just walked me through the whole process and like, okay, now stick it up your nose and like do the swirl. I'm like, okay, great. Now stick up the other one, do the swirl. Okay, great. And then she's like, now put it back in the bag and like tape it shut or whatever. And then she was like, okay, so you see that like drop box, like right up ahead. So what you're going to do, in the other bag, there's two little like sanitizer wipes. So you're going to sanitize the drop box. You're going to put the whole thing in there. You're going to close it shut. You're going to sanitize it again. And then we gave you a Ziploc bag. So you can put those two little sanitizer wipes in the Ziploc bag. And then you're just going to throw that away when you get home. So they had it like, it was all planned out, like every little item and thing was accounted for in this little bag. And she was like, yep. And then you're done. The whole thing maybe took like 10 minutes from the time I arrived at CVS to the time I was driving away with my COVID test, taken. Obviously I left it there. But then it took, I think it was basically 2 weeks, like 13 days or something before I was like checking, online on the online portal, like every day, basically everyone was asking me like, get your test results back. I was just assuming I was positive. Like I was living as if I was, because I knew the bride and the groom had both tested positive. So I quarantined with the two friends that I had gone to the wedding with, because we were like, oh, we were all exposed to the same germs. So might as well just like keep it that way, so I don't expose my roommates, because they didn't want it. So then stayed with them for like a week and a half, eventually went home to my house. My roommates both evacuated. So then I was home alone, they wanted to be extra safe. So then I was home alone for a week and then they eventually came back. But, and then eventually I got my test results back and they were indeed positive. So that was the testing experience.
Wow. That's a short yet long one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now Barbara, you got a test recently. Why don't you talk about that in this conversation?
Well, it was a lot simpler than yours. There's this website called Go Get Tested. And my mom, she's an essential worker, and there's the possibility that she got in contact with someone who had it. So she was like, this is the day, we're going to do it tomorrow. And so we registered the day before, like not even the day before, it was like nighttime. So there was still, it was on a short notice in a way. So you just register and they hardly ask you about anything about it. So then they have like a few locations where you can go to. And there was like in front of this pizzeria in like a random place in Plano. So It was a little like, I don't know where we're going, but it's nearby, so I guess it's going to work. We were really worried that it was going to be through nasal anesthesia. It was really our anxiety of just getting through it. But when we arrived, it was like, no, it is our oral exam. And we're like, yay. Like, we were really worried about it because, I don't know, to be honest, like, we were just kind of like, oh, that's going to hurt. But so we went there and it was super fast. Like, unlike yours, it wasn't like it, do it yourself way. Like, you did it, that they give you the step. It was another person being like, okay, close the windows and cough a bit so you can get a lot of saliva in your mouth. But then the person helped us through it, and they were actually the person who were doing it. And there were a lot of precautions on it as well. They were always sanitizing themselves and whatnot. But it was a lot more involved. It wasn't as involved as you, like, they were doing the steps, them, not us. We weren't like with a bag or anything. It was mostly them doing their steps. And it was really fast like yours. It was like 30 minutes. I think we took more, a little bit more time because I was translating for my mom since she doesn't know English. She only knows Spanish, and the people who were attending us didn't know Spanish. So it was like, smile, and I was like, sonríe, and it was kind of like an awkward situation. Like, the guy is like, please translate. And we're like, there's a lot of moments when I'm translating for my mom and I forget that I have to. So I'm like, oh, she understands. And she's like, no, she doesn't.
So you got your results.
What? Yeah, and it was pretty fast compared to yours. It was a day after. They told us that it was going to take like 2 to 3 days. And it just came the day after without really much notice. It came out negative, thank God. And that was pretty much it. Like, you just get the results and you're like, what do I do now?
Well, like, so you got to, you said you had a couple other questions for Cece about her experience.
Oh, yeah. What would you change now of the video, now that you had COVID-19?
Oh, man. What I changed from the video? Gosh. Honestly, probably nothing. We were actually intentional about not making the video about COVID. We didn't want to make light of COVID itself, because like there are people who are dying, like it is serious, even though like the majority of people are fine if they get it, like myself. So we intentionally like didn't make any COVID references, like no COVID jokes. I'll tell you guys, inside scoop, we were gonna make the main repeatable phrase corona nah, but we decided to change that again because it was like, that was a COVID reference, and we're like, you know, like it's probably fine, but we just want it to be all about quarantine and not at all about COVID. So because of that, I don't think I would change anything about it, because it's about like quarantine specifically. So yeah.
Nice. You got another question?
Yeah, I was going to ask you about a sequel, but now that I know that how you want to focus more on quarantine, I'm not sure about it, but are you thinking about it?
You know, we haven't talked recently, but right after it came out, we were like, man, that was so much fun. Yeah, we have talked about it. There hasn't been any steps taken. Now that we haven't been in quarantine, obviously, this whole time because like the restrictions have been lifted and we've been able to sort of kind of go back to normal life a little bit. But we could do a second one. I'm not sure. We have to put like some other kind of spin on it. Again, probably wouldn't want to make it about COVID itself, but I don't know, maybe something about like quarantine related. I don't know. So maybe is the answer. Maybe.
Awesome. Do you have another one, Mara?
No.
Okay. Well, I'll ask you my last one. How has how has contracting the virus changed your daily life, or has it?
Or how has it changed my daily life? I guess the one nice thing, and there was a part of me, if I'm going to be brutally honest, that was like secretly hoping I might catch it at the wedding, just because I like, there's a bunch of people, and if I'm ever going to get it, like, this would be a good time, because I know I'm young and healthy and I'm in like the very low risk category. And I'm like, and if I catch it, then I can build up some antibodies and then I can like just kind of be that much stronger. And you know, of course there's like all this debate and unknown, like they don't know how long the antibodies last, et cetera, et cetera. But I sort of, at least now, like the first few weeks, like I had it like back in July 3rd, like the beginning of July. So it's been over a month since I've had it. So who knows how long the antibodies last, but kind of these like first few weeks, I've kind of had this, just kind of like a safety knowledge. Like, mm-hmm. I probably, like, I'm a little bit safer, or I have that much better of a chance of, you know, not catching it again or whatever. I'm still safe. 'Cause like, You never know, right? Like, even if you eliminate all of the risk, like, it's actually impossible to eliminate all of the risk. But I've kind of had this kind of background knowledge, like, yeah, I've had it. Like, I probably have a better chance of not getting it again than like some of these people around me who haven't had it. So that would probably be, it's more like an internal change. I haven't really changed any of my habits. Like, I'm still careful, still like do all the, you know, wash my hands after going out, hand sanitizer. Also, I have like some like germophobia OCD going on. So like that, of course, doesn't help. But I would say, yeah, I don't think it's changed my daily life too much, besides having a teeny tiny bit of a feeling of being kind of like Superwoman.
you know, you're a big fan of the super heroes.
Yes, yes.
That kind of fits, doesn't it?
Yep. Yeah, there you go.
well, thank you, Cece Stevenson, for joining us today. Yeah. And it's been a delight to watch your video, and it's thank you for being willing to share your COVID story. We're signing out from Spotlight On.